Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Journey Within online service. We welcome you from wherever you're joining us this morning. We are very fortunate and blessed to have with us Minister Steven Upton this morning and officiant Stella Upton, and we're very grateful to them. I'll tell you a little bit more about them before we move into the direct service. We begin all of our services with spiritual healing. So as we are here together in this way, we would particularly ask for our healers to send healing to those who have joined us, to those all around the planet who are in the need of healing at this time. And may you as well just move into a quiet meditative place as we come together for a little period of healing and meditation. We ask the great unseen healing force to remove all obstructions from our minds and our bodies, and to restore us to perfect health. We ask this in all sincerity and honesty, and we will do our part. We ask this great unseen healing force to help both present and absent ones who are in need of help, and to restore them to perfect health. We put our trust in the love and the power of God. Amen. So if you'd like to just go into a quiet meditative place and feel the presence of healing as the healers send it to you and all around our planet this morning.
Thank you.
has begin to come back from our healing time. We send out healing to all those who have requested healing, for all those in need of healing in the hospitals and the care facilities all around the planet. If there's anyone in the days or weeks to come that you would like to request healing for, you can send an email to the church or leave a message. Patty will get them right away on the healing list. So we appreciate the healers working with that. And I hope you could feel the power of the healing as we just joined together this morning. I certainly do feel it. So as we come to the end of healing, we move into our portion of our service. And we're very blessed to have with us today. First, I'll introduce Minister Steven Upton. He's been involved with the spiritualist movement since 1971. He started attending Arthur Fillion College in 1979. He's responsible for SDU Publications, which is a project dedicated to reprinting out-of-print spiritualist books. It's a wonderful resource if you're looking for some of the classic books. He's a tutor at the prestigious Arthur Findlay College. He's received the Long Service Award of the Spiritualist National Union. And he really travels the world, speaking on the philosophy and the religion of spiritualism, teaching healing and as an exponent as well of transmediumship. So we welcome you, Steven Upton, to us.
Thank you, Jenna.
Thank you. Also joining us is officiant Stella Upton. She's been a tutor with the prestigious Arthur Findlay College as well. She holds certificates of recognition for demonstrating, private readings, public speaking. She's also a wonderful spirit artist, I have to say. And she as well travels the world. She does do online orographs. So if you wanted to have a private session still during this time, you can contact them through their websites. They are very dear friends of ours, I have to say, and we really enjoy their company. And 2 days before they were to arrive here, we made a decision it would probably be best that they not come in person. And I think that was the right decision, as sad as it was, because we have a really good time. So we look forward to being back with you in person later in the year, hopefully. So as we begin the service, we would like to ask one of our guests to open with prayer.
Thank you very much, Janet, for the lovely introduction. Now, if everyone would join with me in prayer, please. Father God, we've all gathered here today within this forum, in your presence, and as an act of communion with you, and also communion with our friends and loved ones in those spiritual realms, those who have gone on before us. And whilst we may miss their physical presence, we know they are but a thought away. And during this service, we ask for your inspiration to help each and every one of us to guide us through these difficult times, but also through the power of mediumship, for that comfort and joy that we get when our friends and loved ones draw close and provide the evidence that life is truly everlasting. And as we invite you and that power that you bring into our world, into our lives, to take us forward down this service, I leave it in your care and keeping. Amen.
Amen. We'll now move into an opening piece of music, which is Anyway. So if you just give me a moment.
You can spend your whole life building something from nothing. One storm can come and blow it all away. Build it anyway. You can chase a dream that seems so out of reach, and you know it might not come your way. Dream it anyway. This world's gone crazy. It's hard to believe that tomorrow will be better than today. Believe it anyway. You can love someone with all your heart for all the right reasons. And in a moment they can choose to walk away. Love them anyway. God is great, but sometimes love ain't good. You can pour your soul out singing a song you believe in, that tomorrow they'll forget you ever sang. Sing it anyway.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege and honor to welcome Minister Steven Upton.
Thank you, Janice. And good morning, North America, and good afternoon, Europe, and hi, wherever you are in the world. It's a pleasure to be here with you today and have this opportunity to address you upon the religion and religious philosophy of spiritualism. Over this last couple of weeks, whilst I've been housebound, we're under curfew, only nipping out for a couple of minutes either go to the post office or to the supermarket, and we now have to keep 2 meters distance as we're going around the supermarket from everybody else. They only allow so many in. We're spending 99% of our time sat at home. But the good side of that is our normal busy lives, as they've ground to a halt, has given me chance to think. And thinking about the current situation we find ourselves in the world right now at this moment, whenever I'm faced with any kind of moral or ethical dilemma, and I'm trying to find some kind of answer to it, the first place I always look is the seven principles. That is the basis of spiritualist philosophy. And very often I can find an answer, a solution, or a reason as to why something's happening. And on this occasion, perhaps not so easy, but I'm drawn more and more to thinking about the sixth principle. And that is compensation and retribution hereafter for all the good and evil deeds done upon earth. Now, initially, when I normally contemplate the sixth principle, I think of it on a personal level. What have I done in my life that's either good or bad, that there's going to be some form of either compensation or retribution for or against. However, what I'm looking at now is something upon a completely different scale. Not so much an individual scale, because I don't really believe one person has created the situation we're in, but I'm trying to look at it now and understand it on a global scale. Is there a collective responsibility? Does the sixth principle not just apply to an individual soul upon their journey through life? Does it also apply to a collective or even a group responsibility? What about the entire human race? Can it have implications for that, for all of us? Is this in some sense, therefore, some form of retribution or compensating for what we've done collectively? And that's really a big thing to try and get your head around. Over this last week or two, I've had conversations with a number of people, and some people saying, is this perhaps God somehow adjusting things, giving us a wake-up call, saying, look what you've done to your planet, don't you think you should do something about it? Well, I'm not so sure about that, because to think of a God that makes those kind of decisions and thoughts, I think he's bringing God down to our own image. People, we as human beings, have those kind of thoughts. I don't think God is a person, and I don't think God is sat somewhere thinking, look at that lot. They made a hell of a mess of that place. I'm going to send them a wake-up call. I don't think it works that way. However, there is something. There are universal laws. And as my mind was pondering on this, the sixth principle, trying to get my head around it, trying to understand, would it apply to the entire human race collectively, I thought of something else, and that is laws. Now, I'm not a physicist. I wasn't terribly well schooled when it comes to physics at school, but I am aware that there is a law, and I'm going to attribute it to Newton, and if there's anybody out there who thinks it came from someone else, please correct me. And that is, every action has an equal and opposite reaction. See where my mind's going now. Every action has an equal and opposite reaction. I think it's become quite clear to, certainly, I think a majority of the world's population, or certainly those that think about it, that our actions collectively, as an entire human race over this last century, is culminating in the destruction of so much of our ecosystem, of our atmosphere, the very air that we breathe, our planet, the seas, our food, everything, the entire system that supports life on this planet, we're actually damaging it. I think there are actually now probably few people who think this is fake news. And evidence to support this, only last night I was looking at satellite imagery of some of the major population centres in the world and how the pollution has changed in only 2 weeks, showing the CO2 levels of major urban populations from 2 or 3 weeks ago, looking at them now, and in a very short time, they've changed for the better. The air is becoming cleaner. The air that we all breathe, that we all rely upon. So I think actually it should be accepted now. We've done a lot of damage to this planet. And if we were to continue, or if we do continue, along this pathway that we've collectively chosen through our commercialization of everything, I think we're going to do irreparable damage. But I also don't think we're at that point yet, but we could very well be getting very close to what they call a tipping point. So here's my thought. Our actions have created the situation of the planet that we're facing right now. If, as Newton states, every action has an equal and opposite reaction, could it be that what we're facing right now in this world health crisis be some kind of reaction? Now, I don't know is the truthful answer. It's just the direction my mind goes in. But could this be the wake-up call? Could this be a message from the universe saying to us, look, stop. We're forced to stop right now. Our governments are shutting down half the world. So we're forced to stop and take notice. But the big question will be, of course, what happens when this is all over? Is this just seen as a temporary blip in our lives? Or will we change? That, of course, has to be left to each individual at first to think about. But will it change our governments at governmental level? Will it change the world at a world level? I don't know. Sadly, part of me thinks probably not. People want to get back to business as usual. But I'm certainly starting to think that not perhaps God, like a man sat somewhere saying, look what you're doing, do something about it. But perhaps universal laws are reacting now in an equal and opposite way to what we've been doing. And if so, there's no changing that except by changing what we're doing. So if this is all fits together, Newton's laws are correct, the laws of physics. If our sixth principle is correct and can be applied to a whole group, the entire human race, not just an individual, what can we do about it? The first thing is, clearly we've got to get past the crisis we're in. But I'd ask you to think very carefully about your lives, how this crisis is changing how you live, how we all live, how we consume, particularly as most of us, I should imagine, that sitting listening to this right now, we're in what is known as the first world. We consume more than the rest and we pollute more than the rest. So perhaps we need to start thinking about this now. What will I do that's different when this is all over? What can I do to encourage others? Because it's very clear to me now, we've gone down an avenue, possibly to the brink where there's no return, but I firmly believe we haven't gone quite that far. And I'm starting to think, even as I'm talking to you now, I feel that inspiration, that power coming into my mind, that yes, this is right. This is the wake-up call for the entire human family. So of course that brings us into quite naturally, our second principle, the brotherhood of man. That means that every single one of us, the entire mankind, the human family, we're equally responsible for all that we do. We have an individual responsibility, we have a collective responsibility. And how I live can deprive others within my family. If I overconsume, if I waste more, but yes, I'm thinking and believing now, this is a wake-up call for us all. We're forced to change right now, but that won't go on forever. Hopefully in another month or two, our lives will start to return to some form of normalcy. But we have to then make choices. Do we want to return back to fully the way we were? Or should we start thinking now, actually, this makes a difference. Travelling less, consuming less makes a difference. Yes, we have to get back to our businesses. Yes, we have to earn a livelihood, put a roof overhead, food on the table. No one's asking us to stop all that. But small changes made by billions of people could make a difference. So those are my thoughts to you here this morning. In line with spiritualist philosophy, we're responsible for what we do. That there is compensation and retribution, and there are laws in nature that every action has an equal and opposite reaction. We've created a chain of events, and perhaps now the universe is reacting. I'm awfully sorry about that. Should have turned the thing off before we started. So I leave those thoughts. I bet it's Stella's mother, actually. Stop.
What noise is that?
It's the phone. It won't stop.
I've switched them all off.
You can't, they'll be still coming in. Don't be sorry about this.
Oh, no worries. We're so glad you're here.
Go away. So yes, just to recap there. We never get that in your church, do we, with phones going off?
Oh, yes, we do.
Not mine anyway. So embarrassing. So yes, just to recap. If nature is, if as I'm postulating here, this is a reaction to our actions over this last century or so of increasing consumerism and increasing materialism, then we need to really sit up and take notice. If this is the wake-up call, then what are you going to do about it? I know I'm thinking about what I'm going to do. What am I going to do because I travel the world? What am I going to do to try and reduce my own carbon footprint? What are we going to do to reduce how we consume? So I leave those thoughts with you to think about, and hopefully they give you some inspiration and guidance to what we can do, not just today or tomorrow, but to change this planet for the future, for future generations. It's them that I worry about more than ourselves. What will our children and our grandchildren inherit of the world we leave behind us? Thank you very much.
Thank you, Stephen, for those very thought-provoking words. I really appreciate it. Usually, if we were at the church, we would be having a collection. So if you're so moved later today at some point to make a donation, a dollar or two, if you go to the website, Karen's made it very easy to us to still have a collection. And we really do appreciate that during these times. We've moved kind of quickly to put all of April events that are possible up on Zoom so we can continue to be in community. So a couple of the events coming up on Monday nights, there is a closed mediumship circle that was here that's still ongoing. On Tuesday nights, there's a open beginner's mediumship class. On Wednesday nights is our regular Wednesday night healing and message service. This coming Thursday, which is April 2nd, Bonnie Grossman will be doing EFT tapping for stress reduction. That's at 7:30 p.m. She is trained in that. So a lot of the events are to help us cope through these difficult times. Next Saturday, there's a class with myself, Foundational Keys to Mediumship. And then next Sunday with us is Reverend Dr. Carol Lynch will be her speaker. We're really looking forward to that. She has published a book, Jump Into Spirit, Our Sacred Connections Enhancing Our Lives. She's an ordained religious science minister with the Centers for Spiritual Living, a licensed psychologist. She has been present in our church, and we really look forward to her. She's a very dynamic, powerful woman. So that will be our guest next Sunday. Ongoing, there are other classes coming up with Reverend Pam. There's going to be a healing service with Mantra. So please join us. And if you visit the Journey Within website, under special announcements and under the events page are all the contact details you will need to get into these. If it's an event at the end of April, you might not have the Zoom ID, but it will appear. So just be patient. All of this will come together week by week. But the whole of the month is up for things that will be taking place via Zoom. If you would like to drop off any food goods, you could leave them here at the Journey Within door. We are still making trips to Patterson. They have requested a stop on clothing for right now. They really are in need of food, actually very desperately in need of food. So, you know, if you're in a position to pick up some pasta or something, you know, that can go a long way that the stores still have, we'll make another trip down to Patterson. We took a full carload down. So it's really very helpful in these tough times for them. That goes down to Kumak and Patterson. We are here in the offices, so if you're in need of help, if you need to just talk with someone, as I mentioned, if you need to put someone on the healing list, please call. We still are manning the church. So I'm very blessed to be here. So I think that's it for the announcements that I can think of for right now. We're going to be moving into our demonstration of mediumship. Before that, we usually have the beautiful piece of music, Where I Sit Is Holy, which I will be putting on. So if you'd like to just go into a quiet meditative place, if you know it, you can sing along, and I'll just be moving to put that on.
Where I sit is holy. Holy is the ground. Forest, mountain, river, listen to the sound. Great Spirit circles all around. Where I sit is holy, holy is the ground. Forest, mountain, river, listen to the sound. Great Spirit circles all around me. Who I am is holy, holy are we. Body, thought, emotion, connecting you and me. Great Spirit circles all around me. What I do is holy, holy is my way. Work and play together, celebrate the day. Great Spirit circles all around me. There I sit is holy, holy is the ground. Forest, mountain, river, listen to the sound. Great Spirit circles all around me. Who I am is holy, holy are we. Body, thought, emotion, connecting you and me. Great Spirit circles all around me. What I do is holy, holy is my way. Work and play together, celebrate the day. Great Spirit circles all around me. Where I sit is holy. Who I am is holy. What I do is holy.
Spirit circles
all around me. Holy is the ground. Forest, mountain, river, listen to the sound. Great Spirit circles all around me. Great Spirit circles all around me. Great Spirit circles all around me.
Where I sit is holy.
Who I am is holy. What I do is holy.
Great Spirit circles all around me.
Holy is the ground. Forest, mountain, river, listen to the sound. Great Spirit circles all around me. Great Spirit circles all around me. Great Spirit circles all around me.
A As we move into our demonstration of mediumship, as spiritualists, we do believe that life is continuous. And through this demonstration of mediumship, seek to reunite those who have crossed over to those who are still here. It's a little bit different on Zoom. So you do have the ability, as Stella comes in, to raise your hand. We would only ask you to raise your hand if you can take 90% of what she's saying. If you can understand the information, at least 90% of it, please raise your hand. Otherwise, I'm going to keep all hands lowered at this time. So I'll introduce Stella, and I don't know if you can see the hands there, if you want me to monitor that, Stella.
I can't.
I think you might have to move to one computer. Just one moment. Luckily, Steven is good at this. And it's much more techno savvy than me. So, how are we thinking things are going there? Stella, can you? Hi, Stella, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, turn the volume up.
Okay.
Can you hear me okay?
Yes, I can.
That's better, isn't it? Well, hello, everybody.
I'm going to lower all hands, so please don't put your hands up until Stella has given the body of information. And you can take at least 90% of what's said. So thank you, Stella.
That's okay. I'm very aware here of a lady in the spirit world, and I feel that this is grandmother. Now then, I am aware of the name of Lily. It might not be her name, but certainly that's what I'm aware of. But also Elizabeth. So whether she was christened Elizabeth and called Lily, I don't know, but I'm hearing both those names. The most significant thing I'm feeling with this lady is that she would have sewed, maybe even for a living. And I'm seeing an old Singer machine, and a pedal variety of machines that were around a while back. So this is what I'm seeing her doing. And she would have done quite a lot of sewing in her younger days. I feel with her a very chatty person, a very loving person, and someone you would go to just to have a bit of conversation and just to spend time with. She would be somebody who would very well look after you. I know that there would have been arthritis towards the end of her life, and I feel a little bit sad at having to give the sewing up. Now, who can understand the information so far? Tracy can. No, quite a few. Okay. And I'd be most interested if those of you who can understand this information, if her name was either Elizabeth or Lily, or she was called Elizabeth, but everyone called her Lily. That seems to be quite significant for me. Okay. I also, so we've got a Lily. She would have used an old Singer treadle machine. She would have done sewing, not just for the family, but for other people as well. She would have had paid work with this. I am feeling that she's in the United States. I'm definitely feeling that. I know there's people are online here all over the world, but I'm definitely feeling that she's in the United States here. I also feel that I wasn't born here, or my parents weren't born in the United States. I feel that originally the family were from another country and would have migrated to the States. Very happy about that, she seems to me. Okay. I also feel she looks to me to at least be late 70s, 80s when she passed to the spirit world. She still seems all the time be very chatty. She was always like that. She liked to travel up until the end of her life, but she would still talk about all the places she'd been to. She was a very good conversationalist. She liked to spend time with people. She just loved company. So I have one person left with a hand up, and that is Tracy. Is it possible to speak to Tracy then?
Yeah.
Okay. Her mic's off.
She needs to turn the mic on.
Yeah, Tracy, can you just turn your unmute yourself for a minute, please? Trying to talk to you, Tracy, please. Can you turn your mic on?
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to have my mic on.
Yes, that's okay. So, Tracy, you understand everything so far?
No, I understand none of it. I didn't have my hand raised.
But you had a blue hand raised, which is what Jonathan asked me to do. That's a hand raised.
I'm sorry. I clicked it by mistake.
Okay, then. Thank you for speaking to me anyway. And can you mute yourself again, please?
Of course.
Thank you. Now, I only need you to put your hand up if you understand everything or most of what I have said. We have Susan, who has raised your hands. Can I talk to you a moment, Susan, please? Susan Marikakis. Sorry if I pronounced your name wrong.
That's okay. Can you hear me?
I can.
Okay.
Now, do you understand everything that has been said or just some of it?
I understand all of it except for the name, but I get it where the name Lily will come in from.
Okay, then that's fine. So long as you understand that, that seemed very important. She seemed to be very adamant at me presenting that for the contact. So that's fine if you understand it elsewhere.
Okay. I can.
Now, I know that as she's coming around you at the moment, this time, apart from all this illnesses and isolation that's going on at the moment, there must be some anniversary or birthday around now in the family. Would you understand this or not?
Absolutely.
Because I know she's come for different reasons, particularly to give you strength and let you know that she's watching over you at this time. But I know there's something particular about this time. Okay. And I know that she must have liked music. I'm not aware of music playing as she's coming to talk to me, but I'm aware of her singing along to things. So as she's working, I want to sing, I would hum a tune.
Yes.
And I'm listening to the rhythm of the sewing machine here. And it's just inspiring me, because I know she didn't always use patterns, you know, the proper patterns that you buy from the shop. She would make her own up.
Yes, absolutely.
She was very good at that, actually.
Yes, I have them.
Oh, how fantastic is that? Now, I know that she also would have knitted and done other things. She seemed to be very crafty in that way. But it was sewing that was her life, I feel.
Yes.
And it wasn't just clothes, because she's showing me all kinds of things here, bedspreads, cushions. So, yes. And I know another reason for her coming forward at this time for you is that there's somebody trying to refurbish or refurnish their home at the moment, trying to see where they can save up for this or where they can save up for that, or if I'm able to make this and that like she used to do. Now, does that make sense to you at this time?
Yes, I just reupholstered my bench with her old material yesterday.
Fantastic. That is so lovely. Well, yes. She often knows about that then. And I know there must be somewhere, I know you're talking about old material of hers, but I'm aware of a bundle of old material of hers. Maybe that was sewn up into something else at one time, but are still there to make things out of. Would you understand this? Because I feel excited and want to inspire you to use what's kind of, it's almost like, but what's the point of having all that in the cupboard if you're not going to use it?
Okay? Exactly. Yes, so absolutely. That's so funny.
She's talking about having sore hands with all the sewing, but she just loved it, that she just tried to find creams and things that would take her through the work that she so loved to do.
Yes.
Would you understand this at all?
Yes.
But I know, as she's coming to you at this time, you must understand that there's some skin irritation with yourself.
Yes.
Because she wants to just bring you a talk, just acknowledge that she knows about it. She's watching over you. She knows what's happening in your life. And there is so much love with this lady. However, having said that, and having known that I absolutely adore you, if you asked her a question, she'd be very blunt with her answer. She would tell her way. She wouldn't just, you'd have to not expect what you wanted to hear. She'd be quite blunt with you and very honest and down to earth. This is so, isn't it?
Yes, absolutely. Yes, hard-headed.
She hasn't changed, I have to say. I love it. Okay.
Awesome.
I know that she would have watched the old films, particularly the musicals, on the television.
Yes.
I'm going way back in time with that because I started with the black and white. So I know that she would have loved them. Things like, you know, Singing in the Rain, the popular films like that, Carousel, she's making me aware of. And, you know, how can you feel down in the dumps when you are watching listening to such beautiful music and singing along with the words? So I know that she's trying to inspire you in these difficult times, as she would do in her physical life. That is true, isn't it?
Yes, absolutely.
Now, what do you understand? She keeps talking about you having a knitted shawl of hers, or her knitting a shawl for you.
Okay. I have her shawls that are crocheted.
Okay, then perhaps I heard it wrong. I just felt this must be a shawl that she knitted in your possession.
Yes, I have it.
Oh, yeah, okay, because I know that I felt it was knitted by her, not just a shawl of hers, you see.
No.
So I know that it's just to prove to you that she comes around you, she knows what's going on in your home. Even though sometimes you think, well, I'm not hurting you. I can't always hear you properly. Are you actually there at all? So she's really come to say, well, yes, I am. Where do you think I'm going to be here? Okay.
Yes.
Very proud of her family. Would you also understand that there's a son of hers in the spirit world?
A son?
Yes.
I don't know. Unless it was a miscarriage that we never knew about.
No, it was a gentleman, perhaps. He looks to me to be in his 30s, 40s, maybe. So we're going back in time, but not that far.
Maybe her stepson, but I don't know.
Would be it then, because I know I heard the word son.
Okay.
So
I'll keep that in mind.
Yes, please do. But do you not understand a stepson who is in the spirit world? You said you understood a stepson.
I don't know, because you were bringing her in as my grandmother. She was my great aunt who was like a grandmother to me.
Okay. So, and I certainly went with what I was feeling. I have to be totally honest.
Okay. So it's there, and I'll keep that in mind. I have to just figure out who that would be.
Okay, let me just tell you, I don't obviously want to give you a problem here.
No, don't. That's okay.
You don't understand a gentleman that would have passed very quickly with either a heart attack or something quick like this. It wasn't an accident. Who she would have known and respected and had a lot of love for.
Oh, gosh.
I think that this is going to be one of those things that won't come to your mind straight away, and I might have got something wrong.
No.
You have to acknowledge that fact. So if you do manage to find him, then please just get back to me and let me know. You don't understand the name of Michael in the family then?
Michael?
Yeah. And it's Michael I'm hearing and not Mike.
Michael. I believe maybe on her husband's side, but I don't associate with them because our husband passed too. So they live in Hawaii.
Okay. Don't worry about it. I was just vaguely aware of him there, or her speaking about him. It's more important that you know that at this time she is here for you and she is around you, and she's just as chatty as she always was. And the last thing I need to say to you is she really wants me to tell you that you have heard her, but you question whether it was her or not.
Yeah.
Yes. And she's saying, yes, it was me. Kiss me. And you will start to hear me more, because I just want to talk to you because I just love you so much.
Yes.
Okay? So do know she's with you, and thank you very much for
thank
raising
you. And I want to let you know that I have her sewing machine in my home.
Oh, how fantastic.
Yeah, I put it, it's on display, and the lilies are because Easter's coming, and every year at this time, like April 1st, we have to buy the Easter lilies. So she's probably nagging me to buy them.
Yes, I only heard lilies. So I probably took.
Yes, no, it makes complete sense. So thank you. I appreciate that. I needed that today. Thank you.
Thank you very much for speaking.
Thank you.
Okay, so if you can just remute yourself, I'd be very grateful. Thank you so much. Okay, now then, as I'm moving on, I'm already aware of a gentleman that's coming in to my thoughts and my awareness, and I know that this is Father. This is definitely Father, because I'm hearing I'm Dad. Okay, you can't get much clearer than that. I'm Dad, and I feel very proud of my family. I feel I need to come to a daughter who is online somewhere. It doesn't feel like an elderly man to me. He feels younger than that. And he's just saying to me, it's funny you should talk about a heart attack, because that's exactly what took me to the spirit world. So I feel here he may be in his 60s or early 70s at the latest. He looks younger to me. So, and I feel it's a heart attack. He was outside the house, he wasn't inside the house, and he was gone to the spirit world very quickly. Somebody understands the name of either Bill or William. Again, I'm hearing those two names together. So that's quite clear. He seems to be a very loving man, a very hard-working man, and there may have even been some at some point work on a building site or some connection to building work. Now, does anyone understand anything I have said so far, please? Karen. Okay, and Anna. Okay. So if you understand everything I've said, then just raise your hand, please. Only if you understand everything I've said so far.
Two.
Okay. Now then, again, I'm more pulling towards William than Bill. I've heard that name now three times, and it's the full William that I'm hearing. So that must be relevant to your father in the spirit world, or very close in the family, because it feels like that to me. He feels a very loving man. And it was a big shock for the family when he passed away. It was a big shock to him, he's saying. And for him to say that, I know there's a sense of humour there with him. Which of course is still there with him, and still he's wanting to bring this humour around the family at this time, but particularly a daughter. I don't know if there's more than one daughter actually, but I know there must be at least one daughter online today. So this is where I'm looking. I'm looking for a daughter who's online now, who knows about my sense of humour, who knows that I would get down on my hands and knees and play with you when you were a child. I loved it. I'd even play with dolls. Okay, so this is him. It seems we get more, not less. How can it get more? It's growing, Janet. It's growing. Okay, but who, if you're raising your hand now, you must understand everything that I have said so far. The name of William is very important. A heart attack with a dad. He's quite young to me. Certainly he looks to be in his 60s to me. Maybe later 60s, but certainly he is no older. From what I'm seeing, he has dark hair. He's not bald. He has dark hair, maybe slightly graying, but it's dark. He's a larger man. He's not a slim man, although he would have been in his earlier days, he's telling me. Okay, and I feel here that there is a connection to Italy within the family. I don't know if he was Italian. He doesn't feel so to me, Okay, so I'm talking now to Karen. Oh, and now she's gone now. Oh, she's there again. Karen Culkins. Is it possible for you to come and talk to me, please? Can you just unmute yourself, Karen?
Hi there.
Hi. You understand everything I've said so far, or most of it?
I understand everything but the heart attack.
Okay, do you understand then, because I got a terrible pain across my chest when he came in. Do you not understand a pain in the chest going all the way across my chest? You don't understand that?
Not as the final, it may have been the final way he died.
Okay.
He didn't pass quickly.
Sorry?
He didn't pass quickly.
Okay, let me go over that, because I don't feel a long going illness, you see, with him. I don't feel like an illness that went on for year after year.
Correct.
What I do feel is I didn't feel well, but then I passed. It wasn't like I didn't feel well and I passed straight away. I didn't feel well for a while, and then I was gone to the spirit world. Correct. So that's how I feel. I was not well for a while, but then I was quickly gone.
Yes.
I do not understand that.
Some of it, yes.
Okay. That's what it was like for him. Because what's his mission here, seemed to be a mission here for him today, is to make the family realize that what the pictures, when he comes around, and there must be photographs up of him because he can see photographs of himself up. And it's almost like when people are looking at these photographs, they're imagining what he went through. And he's saying it wasn't like that. He wants to put those visions out of people's minds and say, yes, I was ill, but then all of a sudden, was in the spirit world. He wants you to know that. Would you understand this?
Yeah.
Good. And he's a happy man. He has got a wonderful smile, wonderful eyes. And he would joke about being good looking. Would you understand this or not?
Yes.
Because as I'm aware of him, he's looking in the mirror here. Every time he walks past one in the hallway or whatever, he said, "You're handsome, you." And then it's carrying on. So this humour, I love his humour. So, and this is what he wants to be remembered for, is his humour and the fact that he's actually still around you, but you know it because you talk to him, he's saying. Is this true?
Yes.
Good, because it's nothing like having a conversation. And even though I'm in the spirit world, we can still keep talking to each other. You still know when I'm there. You still can smell me. I don't know quite what he means by that, because I'm not aware of aftershave. But would you understand why he would say that?
Yes.
Oh, then that's fine. And I know that as I was talking about the photographs, there must have been some photographs that have been changed. Not recently, but maybe a month or two back. Would you understand this? Photographs of him where he's on his own?
No.
No, okay, that's a shame that, because he's making me aware of this. He's not aware of where there was a photograph that was changed then and prefers the other one. It's almost like he made a change of something and the other is better looking in another one. That's what I'm seeming to be feeling and picking up.
It could be in my sister's house.
Okay.
If he changed it.
Okay, this may be information then that you don't know about, in which case it's probably good evidence for you. You need to speak to your sister about this afterwards and perhaps drop me an email if you remember and get round to it to let me know. Because it seems to be very important for him, for the family to realise that he's still around and he's noticing what's going on. Okay. And as it's coming around you now, he had this way with him, where if you said, "Oh, Dad, this, that, and the other, I'm worried about this, I'm worried about that," he'd always try and find something positive for you to look at. Do you understand this with him?
No.
No. Okay. Well, all I can say to you is that he's wanting very much for you to look on the positive side, to find positive things, particularly where there is someone around you at the moment who is looking at all the negative things, and you may be at a loss as what to tell them, what to say to them. Would this make sense to you or not?
Yes.
Okay, then that's more relevant then. So this is what I'm feeling, and I know he's around and he wants to help you with this. And there's such a lot of love with him, but I just feel a little bit sad that I didn't get chance to say a proper goodbye to you and say how much I love you and how proud of you I am. So that's another reason why I'm coming today. Would you understand that?
Yes.
Okay. And there's a birthday coming up shortly.
Yes.
Because he's saying happy birthday.
Oh, actually, it was his birthday coming up very shortly.
Oh, I was saying happy birthday to himself.
Him?
I don't believe that that is so, actually. I didn't feel it was his. There's not another birthday in the family at all, because he keeps showing me birthday cake here, so I don't think it's happened yet.
Okay.
Okay, but just remember it's been mentioned, okay? And I know where a dog was passed in the spirit world. He's saying the dog is with me.
Okay.
So, yes. Thank you very much for being here this morning, and just know your dad is so in awe of you. He so loved you to bits.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you for speaking to me. Thank you, everybody, for being here.
Thank you so much, Stella, for being with us this morning. We really appreciate it. That now brings us to the end of service. Someone had asked, could they donate money for us to bring to Kumak? You could certainly do that. And just make a note for Karen that there's a donation for us to buy money for Kumak, which we would be happy to do as well. So that was something that came up in the chat room. You were with 186 people here in your congregation this morning, and I know for some of you, you're just learning Zoom and coming onto this new world, so we'll be very patient, you know, in the next month as you come to understand this new technology. But we're so grateful to have it, I have to say, because we get to be with our dear friends, Stella and Steven Upton, whose visit we really deeply did miss this year. So as we come to the end of service, we would ask for one of those guests to close with a prayer before we close with our closing song.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in prayer. Father God, we thank you for bringing this all together within these times not so easy for us to find a way forward. We thank you for being within your love and the light of your divine power. We know our loved ones in the spirit world watch over us so closely at this time, trying to help us, trying to give us that strength and a positive attitude to pass on to others, to help them find their ways. As we come now to go our separate ways, help us to be strong, that we may be an inspiration to all those who are in need. We pray for all those who are suffering, and we give thanks to the doctors and nurses and all volunteers who are working so hard on our behalf. We give grateful thanks, and please help them to find the strength to continue for as long as we need it. Amen.
Amen.
Don't give up, it's just the weight of the world. When your heart's heavy, I will lift it for you. Don't give up, because you want to be heard. If silence keeps you, I will break it for you. Everybody wants to be understood. Give up, because you want.
to burn bright. If darkness blinds you bright, I will shine to guide you. Everybody wants to be understood. Well, I can't be.
Thank you, everyone. Have a wonderful day.